the companies or the funds that are still involved in that. Paul Singer is NML Capital, to name one.
Yeah.
What are they looking for in an outcome here? What are they hoping for?
I think in reality, what everyone's looking for is a change in government as being the actual solution to this problem.
Okay.
That will happen at the end of 2015, and the three presidential candidates that have gained the most in the polls are all more market-friendly people.
But you just said 2015, so that means that this is going to carry on conceivably between now and the end of next year?
Yes, exactly, and that in an emerging market, that's like a decade, because so much can happen. The macroeconomic things can change, everything can change, and the government itself could change between now and then multiple times, as we've seen in Argentina.
Okay, you just talked about market-friendly candidates. What impact would that have?
The hope is that these candidates, regardless of their political parties, are going to want to reap the benefits of fixing this and having potentially 8 years of boom in Argentina, because essentially if they fix this problem, if they allow Argentina to return to capital markets, everyone is saying that this country is going to be a rock star.
So this isn't so much an economic fix that they're looking for. This is a reputational fix, because Argentina again is taking another hit in the international market.
Sure. And the current administration has had this policy of not issuing debt, of not dealing with the holdouts, of not being exactly market friendly.
Yeah.
So the hope is that the next administration is going to see, oh, the cost of dealing with this is nothing compared to the benefits of dealing with this.
All right.